Let's get inside of Blender 3.0 using a Quest 2. And don't worry, for those of you using Steam VR, I'll let you know how to get in as well. For those of you starting with a Quest 2, make sure you have yourself a tethering link cable because it's so much smoother than trying to do this through AirLink. Now, let's go and talk about the software you're going to need. Now, what you'll need to get this to work is obviously Blender 3.0 and the Oculus app. You can get that over at oculus.com/setup and click the big blue button here. Get it downloaded and installed, and then double click it and let's get this started. Inside of here, the first thing you're going to need to do is pair your device. Now, before we pair our device, let's turn on our Oculus and go inside. Inside of our Oculus, we've got to make sure we do one thing in our settings. Right here, we want to be sure that our experimental AirLink is switched off, because if this is on, you will not be able to do normal Oculus Link. With this off, now let's head back over to the devices on our computer. Here, we're going to click Add Headset, then select the headset you're going to be adding, and then we're going to link via cable. Click Continue, and then connect the link to your headset. Once connected, you're going to get this lovely Allow Access to Data pop-up. Make sure you click Allow. Once you've clicked Allow, make sure you enable it. As you can see, it then prompts you to go back to your computer screen. On here, we just need to click Continue, Continue, and that's the setup and pairing done. Now, there's one setting we need to quickly change here, is go over to Settings, go to General, and we want to turn on Unknown Sources On, click Allow on there, and then make sure that openXR Runtime is set Oculus as active. With those two things done, now you're ready to start up Blender. Very quickly, for those of you using Steam VR, make sure you have that launched. And inside of our settings, make sure that you have advanced settings to show. Go to Developer and set this right here to set Steam VR as OpenXR Runtime. And now restart Steam VR. Inside of Blender, it's super simple. All we're going to do is go to Edit, then Preferences, go to Add-ons, and type in here VR. You'll find the VR Scene Inspection. Turn this on, then press N for your right-hand side menu. Go over to VR and click Start VR Session. Now, be aware, we still have this on in the background and the link is currently connected. This is how it's going to work due to the OpenXR runtime currently set as active on the Oculus. So let's turn this on and jump over to our Quest 2. So here we are inside of Blender VR. It's relatively simple to move around. Use your single grip to move around the world. Use double grip to scale the world. Use your right hand thumb to go up and down, as well as rotate left and right. Use your left hand thumb to go forward, backward, left and right. If you want to drop back down to the grid, press A or X, and both of those will get you back to the grid itself. Now there's a couple of extra things that I want to show you, but we need to go back into normal Blender for that. So the first thing I want to point out is the clip start. I like to change these values to work with my unit scale. I usually have them set around about like that. As you can see down here, I have my little 3D view. Now, when I first jumped into VR, you might have noticed that I was inside of my cube. That is because I did not have a camera in the scene. Now I'm going to bring in a camera and take a look how it quickly snapped me to that camera. That's because it automatically turned my landmark as my scene camera. Landmarks are a quick way of jumping around the scene. Now, with this camera here, I can actually just move the camera around and it will move my actual sort of VR view. You can also rotate this camera and it will rotate the VR view. And there's many other powerful things that you can do with this. But I found that using the camera in this way isn't the best. The best way to set up a camera is, instead of it being the scene camera, turn it into a custom object and set the camera in that way. This way, if you're doing precision modeling and you're in a unit scale of 0.001, you can actually change the unit scale of the camera to reflect real-world dimensions like this, because now that cube is only 2 millimeters, and that should be teeny tiny, and this here should be set to 0.1, and also then probably put this up a good few bits so that you're able to see this teeny tiny cube that's right up there. Now, that's only a 2 millimeter cube due to the change of the unit scale. I'll change this back to 100, and I'll also change the camera size to reflect that unit scale sizing as well, and I'll snap it back to the landmark as well. And there you'll have the cube back to the normal real world size due to 1-to-1 scaling. So this is how you can have two different scaling methods, one being precision and the other one being normal. Now, I'm tired of having this window here, so I want to show you one of the coolest things about this, which is down here in the viewport feedback, which is mirror the VR scene. Let's click this on. When I click mirror the VR scene, you've got it. This now turns into a mirror of my VR scene. So I'm just going to move my controller about a little bit here just so that we can get a little better view of that. So this here is my VR view. Now, what I like to do at this point is usually create myself another window that's going to have my normal blender, and I'll set that to my second monitor. I can do this just by dragging out a new screen, but I do find that sometimes things don't quite work out here. I don't know why, it's got to do with whatever's going on, but like, for instance, right this minute, I'm trying to scroll, it doesn't work. But when I actually do this the normal way of bringing in another window, in this other window, I'm able to zoom in and do any changes that I'm wanting to do to the scene in that way. Now, something that's really, really powerful about doing this is the ability of actually doing real-world rendering. But to do that, let's bring in something a little bit more interesting than just a cube. To showcase this next awesome feature, I've got this lovely little model here by Pixel over at Sketchfab. The link to this lovely little medieval scene will be linked down in the description. Now with it all set up, I have currently my eevee rendering on. And what I've done beforehand is I've brought in a cube my size so that I know that everything here is real world size. Now I'm going to bring in a camera, and I'm going to set this camera as a custom object. With that camera now set up as a custom object, I'm also going to set all its rotations down to 0. And now I will turn on my VR session. Now when I turn on my VR session with my headset on looking in the right direction, I'm going to bring in another window. So in this new window here, I'm going to use this as my walk window. So I'm going to select the camera on the right hand side. I'm then going to press 0 to look through the camera right here. Then I'm going to press shift backtick or tilde. It depends on your keyboard. It's underneath escape. So shift that button there. And now we'll be in walk. As you can see, I can now look around and walk in my scene. Now I'm not actually seeing that camera that you're seeing there. So what I'm going to do is I'll right click to cancel that. It will snap me back. I'm going to turn off this so you get to see more along the lines of what I'm seeing on my screen here. And now we'll go back here, press shift backtick. I'm back into walk cycle. I'll tilt my mouse up like this. And now you can see as I move my mouse side to side, it moves my view. And then I can use WASD to move forward. I can press space as well to teleport a little bit. And what I want to show you is right here inside of this lovely little castle, I can just go up to the stairs and start walking up them. Yes, it's a little bit jumpy, but this is now WASD movement in virtual reality inside of a rendered scene. I hope you understand how incredible that is. I'm going to go over here as well just to say hello to this farmer and the cows over here. And you can really tell that you could take this to be anything. It doesn't have to be a low poly scene. You could make this an incredible architectural scene. Whatever it is that you want to do, you can do that. One thing to keep in mind is that if you're wanting to walk on a surface, make sure navigation, you have gravity turned on. Additionally to this, if you really want, you can turn on the VR camera, controller, and landmarks to see where everything is in the VR world space. So I will put my headset back on. I will bring my controllers up, and you can now see where I am in the VR space itself. This is incredibly powerful, and I just cannot believe how easy it's been to set this up. And that there is just the start of it. I have another video where I'm going to show you how to take this to the next level and actually bring a virtual reality window from your computer into the Blender VR workspace. This way, you're able to actually work inside of Blender, inside of the Blender VR workspace. So when you're modeling away, you can see it in 3D in the VR in real time and rendered. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome. And a special thank you to my VIP maker, Jem Ozkinak. If you're enjoying what I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. And don't forget that we have a Discord, and that is linked down in the description. Thank you for watching. Keep making, and let the quest continue.